Reclaiming Philly. What is Reclaiming Philly? Talk about that. In 2010, there were more than 40,000 vacant parcels in Philadelphia. Said that nice little screenshot of what, just a small sample of that. Those vacant parcels caused blight, hurt neighborhood property values, and cost the city millions. Currently, there is no inventory of all the vacant land in Philadelphia. About this, neighborhoods don't know what to do, communities can't plan, and the city is unable to efficiently direct these resources. You live and work next to these properties. You walk by them on the way to school. You can help us remove this blight and improve the quality of life for you and your community. Help us share up-to-date information on the status of these parcels and help us reclaim Philly.
So we started off with a base of information from a variety of places, such as water shutoffs, parcel-related information from disconnected sources. Plan Philly had some information, and we also got some other information from the city. So we decided to cram a bunch of this information and aggregate it into a database so that we could eventually access it. And just some of the information that we had provided had a lot of details, but there were a lot of other spots that we could also aggregate it from, such as opa.phila.gov. This is the Department of Revenue. They had a bunch of information about liens and whatnot. We could get stuff from different places.
So the whole problem is we can't solve this problem in one day. We had a tough time building the app to do it. There are so many data sources, so many places to gather data that it really was cumbersome. So what we ended up doing was taking Boston to do it, adopt the way their map and their layout was perfect for what we wanted to do, adopt the vacant lot and help the communities turn it around. So our idea was to think about user groups that we use as developers, block captures, anyone in that group. And we tried to identify what information they were needed to show, and depending on the user group they're in, we could show it. Now we have a mock-up right here of what we plan to do with it. And this is the wireframe. Rob, do you want to talk about the API for a second?
Sure.
Now, we realized that trying to actually implement something like this was too ambitious for a 4-hour project, but at least we have an idea of where we want to head in the long term, where you need to be able to zoom into a neighborhood centered around an address. So like, for example, supposing there's a place where you live, and you go to a school, you address that, you want to look at the neighborhood and see what the light is around that neighborhood. You can enter the address and zoom to my location. Or if you are in the spot that you want to see where the light is, you don't have to enter the address. Zoom to my location, use the IP address or GPS information if you're home to zoom to my location. And then if you know of some light that doesn't show up after you've zoomed into your neighborhood, then there's also, you can enter an address and click add place to add place in the light. But we were thinking kind of smaller scale for today, and we didn't even accomplish our smaller scale vision, which was just to be able to do a tabular listing of the blight within the neighborhood. Tom and I were in the process of developing a PHP API to pass in an address, and we were going to use the Google Maps API to use that to get coordinates, longitude and latitude, and use that to search the database for longitude and latitude within the radius, and then just print out a tabular list of all the properties.
Thank you.
Next.